We are back again with another epic episode of the LNR podcast. My name is SK, aka Uncle SK. Okay. Hey, namhlanje kumnandi. Siphethe abakhulu abasiphethe. So thank you so much for tuning in. Thank you so much for subscribing. Continue doing that. Today I'm having edwa. Oh, by the way, my team namhlanje ayikho. I have shout out to my kids. I have my kids, a lot of kids. See Badala. So I have my kids, my camera, the switcher. Shout out to them. I'm grooming them. So yeah, so far they're doing great. I'm happy. So today I have Usisi from JM Attorneys. JM Attorneys? JM Hlatshwayo Attorneys. Can you pull the mic towards you? Yes. What does it mean? I wanted to ask before we start. JM? Is it your initials?
Initials and surname.
Okay, initials and surname. Yes. JM. Yes. Uban.
Juliet Malisela Hlatshwayo.
Malisela. Yes. Juliet. Niyaphila.
Niyaphila kunjani?
I'm very well. Thank you so much for joining us. Taking your time. Siyazi nibhizi phela.
Always a pleasure. Thank you.
Thank you so much. Juliet ubani for someone ongamazi who have never encountered problems because in business and I must say king and pale. Ubani ukhulelephi? Just give us a brief just usazise nje ukuthi ubani wena.
Okay, so igama lami nguJuliet wakahlatshwayo. I was born in Limpopo province originally Kimopedi. Mm-hmm. And then you know abazali beza ngapha to come and work at Sasol. From a very young age ubaba wami decided ukuthi I want my children to have a better life. So, uthe umekeza ngapha, he didn't leave me in the villages. So, from the age of about 1 year old, I was already la embalentle. So, I grew up embalentle. I was born in Limpopo, but I grew up embalentle from 1-2 until now. Mm-hmm. I had a break of about 5 years where I lived in Johannesburg. Mm-hmm. That's where I studied for lenting yenza manje, ublawyer.
Oh, tertiary level.
Yes, tertiary level. I went to the University of Johannesburg.
Yes.
But then home called back and I brought back the skills la ngikhulele khona. So I'm currently practicing in Secunda, mm-hmm. but with clients all over South Africa.
Okay, great. Yazi, for someone ongazi, what's the difference between a lawyer and an attorney?
Okay, so a lawyer is like a broad term. A lecturer is a lawyer, can be a lawyer.
Okay.
A consultant can be a lawyer by virtue of you having studied that degree.
Yes.
You know, LLB, BCom, it's very broad. So, but the one abantu abai confuser, usually there's advocate and then there's attorney.
Yeah.
Advocate but specialize in a court, like just going to court.
Yeah.
Then there's attorney. Since I go on, we go to court, we're in the office. The attorney is the client to the advocate.
Okay.
Usually. But since now there's a lot of developments, now advocates can also, some type of advocates can take clients directly from the public. But previously, like in terms of history, I'm an advocate, bewanga tati ama client like a stradini or like uze kuye straight. Previously, u attorney.
Yeah.
The client will go to the attorney. The attorney will be the client to the advocate. But things are evolving.
Hey,
it's quite complicated. Yes.
So, because I saw on one of the cases, I think it was the case YMK Nanani. Bekukhona u advocate. Is it advocate?
My case of money.
No.
Dali Mpofu.
Yes. So Dali Mpofu had someone speaking on that case, but he was just communicating with them. So what was the dynamic around that?
Yes. So we have also something called a principal.
Okay.
Yeah, so Dali Mpofu is actually one of the very good examples or umuntu who we can look up to because he's a person who grooms youth. Most of the time, he will go with younger lawyers. There will always be like a younger lawyer. Yes. So njengobuyenza namhlanje, you are the experienced photographer. Mm. But uze nabantu obagroomayo ukuthi guys.
Oh.
And then there will be leaders who will, they don't mind to sit back and let the junior do the work. So that's why I admire him so much. Mm. Whether like he's losing a case or winning a case, but he does give other young lawyers a chance. So you can find that he's the senior, he's the principal, or he's the senior advocate. But you are niggas are omunye ituba. They probably in the background work together, did the planning and everything. Then, but in terms of presentation, one niggas, I'll give an example. One of the young advocates he's working with, who's a close acquaintance of mine, Advocate Lerato Muela. Mm-hmm. So Advocate Lerato Muela, he's more junior or he's junior. And then Advocate Dali Mpofu is more senior. But you can see he's not scared with him. But it doesn't interfere. He lets him present the case. So that's what usually happens. And kona my case, I'm cool. You'll find, you know, kona if I let nane, you'll find it look like... like 20 pages, but then you find files that have like 5,000 copies where we actually have to delegate the work. Okay, when Stella will focus on this section, Stella will focus on this section. So files like that, that's why sometimes the court, you can have one file and I'm advocate
A5. Yeah, yeah.
Because of the volume of the work. So that's why sometimes you find more than one lawyer in a case.
Mm. Yeah. Sure. So, talking about you, what inspired you to become a lawyer, and what drives your passion for the legal profession?
So, you know, with me, you know, and this is where I'd like to give all the glory to God. You know, if...
Please bring the mic closer.
If you know my background and you know my story, you'll know that it was just grace. Umangiya e University of Johannesburg kuyofunda ilo.
Yes.
I had never set foot in a courtroom. I didn't know even ukuthi iloya ligqoka igown li angaze, like I never, you know, and we don't have asikhulanga thina nama YouTube. Youth yamanje, like they have that access to no ama series. Sikhulanga nama series thina besibukela iTV lapho Timothy no Tabitha. Ngo 4 yabo days of our life. We never had like that exposure to the world, you know. So literally what happened when I was in grade 11, bekuza labantu bama career day expo, what. So one of the people advised me, which, no, whatever you're going to study, you need to ubeke ama subject wakho ukuthi strong an. Are you strong with maths? Are you strong with language? Are you strong with what? I was not strong with maths. Being shy maths. Pure maths being shy. But I was very strong with theory. Like I would get 90%, you know, for theory subjects, your languages, you know, business studies.
Yes.
I was very good with that.
Yeah.
So the lady advised me, ukuthi, why ungabheki like about social work, about teaching, into ehambelana nokuthi uzofunda kakhulu, yabo, i-law in, yabo. So I chose, you know, we are choosing, ngithi ma when you choose a career, you go for your first option, second option, third option. My first option was it was social work.
Yeah.
Because I love helping people, and that's what I knew. I'm a social worker when I been was.
The second
now, you know, especially if you grow up in Lokshin.
Yeah.
Then there was teaching, because we're all exposed to teachers. And obviously, we all think, you know, when you still, you think, teacher, you know.
We put them in
the highest regard. True. And then the third one, because I had to choose something, I just ticked law. It's like, I tick another. I didn't know though, you know. So I applied a lot of universities. I got accepted at UJ.
Yes.
I think they didn't have space, or they didn't have social work, and they didn't have space for teaching. They bangithatha for ilaw. Ngathi ngiyaphuma elokishini, guys.
Yeah.
Angisanendaba nje nokuningi, ngiyohlala down, you know, I'm going to shower every day. I had never taken a shower before. I'm going to shower every day. I'm going to have my own space. And then I started studying law. Yes. And then mangiloko, like in attending my class, I'm like, no, but this is interesting. You know, kulunga ama divorce, kulunga ngani. I'm like, no, but you know, I started to develop now this passion. And then you do ama practicals.
Yeah.
And then they take you to court and you're like, hey man, this thing is actually very nice.
Yeah, you so started enjoying it.
Yeah, yes. And then because I had a passion for people and helping people, it just started to develop. The more ngenza my case. And now it's like, I can't imagine myself waking up and doing anything else. That's why you find that with, like, you'll find kind of client younger patali gal. But you
let's do that. So clients in what way? Establishments or just a normal
like
person?
You know, like,
so
you
what do they do? Do they negotiate the price? What happens when you say they don't pay?
You know what, ne? in terms like in society,
yeah,
I'm a lawyer aziwa as rich people. Like, we know lawyers to be like, man, I'm going to have an 80 or so. What's going on with this person? Lawyers are rich, you know, because generally legal fees are expensive, right? Whether you are working for companies or you are working for the private client, because, for example, to open a file, you'll spend more or less 5,000. That's a lot of money. It's not like actually money, but you know, it's a lot. You know, our hourly rate ranges from maybe 1,500, 2,500, 5,000, 10,000, depending on your experience, of course. But in average, a lawyer in an hour should be making at least 1.5. So just calculate 1.5 times 9. Just play with numbers. So generally, we are known as rich people.
Sure.
But bese kufika umuntu maybe ohola i 5,000 or ohola i 10,000.
Yeah.
Like, kuleyo 10,000 mele ngiphile ngayo. I can't give you my whole salary
just
for one day.
Yes.
You understand? Because generally a lawyer would earn 15,000 rand per day. This is only like approximate figures.
Yes. Because obviously they are, I would say, good days.
They are good days. You see, but in general, that's how much you should be making.
Sure.
Oyabon. Mm. So there are people who come to you and say, I really need your help, but I don't afford.
Yeah.
You know, I recently had a client who went to a certain free organization.
Yeah.
And he's not working, he's not earning. Agana mali. What's maga figure lapa? But yes, ngalendlela sinama file amaningi akhona.
We can't help you.
We can't. Sure. Even if we can say sizoyithatha case yakho, maybe sizokunaka after 3 months, of which it won't be fair to you because you need the help urgently. Mm. Then the person comes to you and say, you know what, Mamhlatshwayo, I'm having the uyabona ukuthi umuntu uye jail or they're about to lose their life.
Yes.
But then because you have the spirit of God in you, you can't allow yourself to let that person go without being assisted.
Because you're not a robot, you're still a human.
You're still a human being. Yeah. So we do have those challenges in the profession.
Talking about the free, what do you call them?
Free lawyers.
State lawyers. I don't know. Maybe it's just my mind. I'm exposed in a corner. I'm not very exposed in terms of listening to the law. But I feel like sometimes they're just pushing cases. Community service. Is there something like that? Or do you think there's some sort of thing like that?
So, you know what?
Do you become one sometimes?
State lawyer? No. Oh. I'm not. I'm not a state lawyer. I'm a private lawyer. So.
Because I just want to differentiate there.
Yeah.
The state do they sometimes call private lawyers to and come and help us or whatever? Like doctors. You can have a private surgery, but still go to
a hospital. Yes. Yeah. No, with a law firm.
Yeah.
It's very legal profession is very different, but I'm glad you're going in that line of discussion because this is a question I get every single day, like in my inbox, on a daily basis. I get at least 20 questions is finally it's good, okay, but can I give you maybe 100 rand a month? The day in Kinga, Beso Young Caesar, or is she? But we'll get to that, See, na sebenzi njengabo doctor in that respect, ukuthi unga uyaka state bese uphinde ube ngapha. Uya choose ukuthi is either uba ku private or uba ku public.
Okay.
So when you are on public, ama client they don't pay you. Like they're not even allowed to give you money because you're working for the state.
Yeah.
You're deriving an income.
Yeah.
For example, if you're arrested and you're not working, every day there's a, I don't want to say free lawyer.
Yeah.
A lawyer.
Someone who can help you. Yeah.
Who says what sets his own you put it like a court in it?
Yeah.
Lo put it in the tattoo medu a mahala. No, I'm a patello. This is what she got. Yes. Just that you're not paying me.
Yeah, but government paid by someone else.
But usually they call them a lawyer wa mahala. Yes. A state lawyer. Let's say state lawyer.
State lawyer, yeah.
So you have to choose. It's either you're on private or you are on public.
Public, yes.
So, public, you go to court, if you're arrested, you're not working. But it's for indigent people. So, umuntu nga afford. You can't be like earning 15,000. So you want to put strain on state resources.
But what if at that stage my finances doesn't allow it?
No. It's for specifically for indigent people. So they have, I think the scale, you need to be having a joint household income of, I can't remember the exact number, but I know it's around 10,000 rand. You can't be earning more than that. Previously, it used to be 5-7, but it's around those numbers. Yeah. So if you're earning like 20 or you... maybe you're earning 15, but for that month, it might say pelil. You can't say for this month, it might say pelil. It needs to be like a general thing, which you're earning this much and you are classified in this category, you can afford or you can't afford. Yeah.
Sure.
So it goes for certain income income groups.
The reason why I asked this, I remember during COVID, we got arrested. I know my family doesn't know this. My parents don't know this. So we got arrested. So what had happened? We were shooting a music video. I mean, there was no income. We're trying to, we're trying to push things. So we hired a space somewhere in Evander. So I shoot a music video. I'm gonna get paid. I mean, we need money.
Yeah.
So. I figure my police got arrested. Ah, I'm sorry.
Hectic.
They let us go same day. I think around 7, they let us go. Now we have to attend the case. You need to come at this day, blah, 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 sharp. I think there were 7 of us, 6, 5, somewhere up. Then got arrested. Yeah, then... we started attending the case. The thing is, we angena, then they tell you, remanded. Do they need more evidence? What's happening? Because now, it was the COVID regulations, and we felt like our lawyer, because Basnika is a lawyer, and they didn't ask, do you afford? Do you? And we're like, we are there. So the lawyer, at the end of the day, they agreed on community service.
Okay.
So we had to paint a school, but I feel Uguti, there was nothing that happened there. You just maybe wa nibizan ukuvuma nje maybe agreement like a settlement sort of, I don't know Uguti isebenza kanjani. So that's why I'm like bayakhuluma yini ukuthi hayi inkosi enkantolo or whatever, because a normal person, a John Estradins ekasi, would not know such things. That's why sometimes if you don't get, you learn new things. But yeah, so is there any notable case that you worked on and it was like a standout for you on your career? This one was difficult, but and if there is, why push a and how did you maneuver or how did that case go?
Yo, you know what, ne? I feel like I'm a soldier of God.
Yeah.
I'm having so many difficult cases.
Yeah.
Yo, my nini. Okay, there is one that I can think about, as much as we are not really allowed to disclose.
Yes, okay, of course.
Like, I'm a case, especially like if you don't have consent from the client. But I also generally don't like ugabona. Like Hlatswayo lawyer, like so was already. I will give just there's a case I worked on. My client was about to lose his property against a very big organization. Like I mean, big.
Yeah.
You know, I'll just give an example. It was not this organization, but it big like a Sasol. Can you imagine? Like
one person versus. Sure.
That's a corporation, multi billion rand corporation, you know?
Those people have access to any lawyer, any big lawyer.
Yo, big. So this client came from Gauteng.
Yeah.
Can you imagine? Usuke Gauteng. Was a consultant, I'm like Secunda. You know?
Yeah.
He was about to lose everything, like his business, everything, his house. Everything, because legal expenses are like legal fees are high, and especially if you're going against the best of the best, municipality or big Eskom, they don't go for they go for the very best.
They want to win,
you know, they want to win, and they have those type of 5 lawyer team kind of strong vibes, you know. You can't just get there with your one person.
Yeah.
The guy came to me and said, Hlatswayo, I'm about to lose everything. I heard from you, Gubanbani, who works at the Daily Sun.
Yeah.
and I've been through like 3 or 4 lawyers, mm-hmm. and angikho happy.
Yeah.
And ikhesi yangena kusasa. He came today. He's like, I bengibona man ukuthi
you know,
as communicator and the lawyer lami, and kusasa siyangena, can you help me? And I said, okay, bring it on. And I put together a team. He said, I don't have money now, but this is my budget for now. I can give you this as a deposit. Mm-hmm. We did that case. And I was traveling from Secunda to Johannesburg to do that case. Mm-hmm. You know, in the bengithanda ngalo baba ne, like he was very cooperative. And bekubaba omdala, I think he was bekubaba nje almost my dad's age.
Yeah.
But bekangana lento yokunyatsa ukuthi but what can I
yabantwana
uzongitshelani wena, you know.
Yeah.
He had absolute faith in me. And we won that case.
Mm.
You know, and I also made, you know, I did make some money from it.
Yeah.
But it's just one of the cases that stood around for me ukuthi what the message that it gave me, Guti, when you are good at your work, people will travel all over the world to come to you. No mung abase plazini, but just be so good at your work that people will just come, people will support you.
Yeah.
You know, and tina gakulu mina, like I'm working a lot on referrals. Uguti ifemi is a ime ganje, it's referrals. Uwenza umsebenzi omuhle for one person, and they tell the next person, and they tell the next person. And that's literally how the business has sustained itself the past 4 years.
Yeah, sure. So with all the changes to legal landscape, do you guys have to go back to school or you just learn as it comes?
You know what? If ufuna ukuba ummeline, you need to be a permanent student. This morning, before we were doing Senzali interview, I had to read about 5 case laws. It's about more than 400 pages.
Yeah.
Just to prepare for a case. So if you don't like reading and studying, you're going to have a problem. But we don't have to go back to school. But you need to always keep yourself updated. Like if you don't have exposure, you're going to have a problem because uzofika lapho ukhothe umthetho outdated because
so umthetho kahle kahle is always
it's always evolving
ne?
Always evolving. And I mean, I like, you know, there are type of clients who will say, I don't agree with the law in terms of this principle, I want to challenge it.
Yeah.
And remember, we have constitutional court. Like, for example, the recent case laws of our former president, Babu Jacob Zuma.
Yes.
You know, he went on to say, no, this is unconstitutional. What, I don't agree with the law. Yes, the law says 1, 2, 3.
Yeah.
But mina, I don't agree. But to do that, ne, there's one advocate, I'm trying to see a case. Ne.
Yeah.
And I said to him, the client doesn't have money. Ne. But it's a matter of principle. Then he said, the client must have money if they want to have principles. So keep that in mind. Which is to challenge
you need
the law at that level, you need deep pockets.
Mm.
Yeah, because you're not going to say, challenge the law here in event. Or Secunda must go to high court.
Yeah.
Those are the courts that have powers to sort of develop the law. La guma magistrate court, our smaller towns, we are just applying the law.
Oh.
Yeah, they're not really, you know, changing. They are just applying. If you want to change the law, you must go high court.
Mm.
So, Supreme Court,
yeah.
Constitutional Court.
Mm. So, ngobusayi balaganja alo, sikala, abizwa ngani, mfuna ungibrekele wena down until isifika le Constitutional Court. Sikala kuphi? Municipal?
Yeah, no, that's a good question. Sicala ku small claims court, there are tribunals and what, our rental housing tribunal and what.
Yeah.
Then the small claims court. Khona my case uthola ukuthi maybe uJabu ukolota 5,000.
Yeah.
You don't need to come and pay me 5,000 to go and go after Jabu for 5,000.
Yeah.
The small claims court where like they don't need lawyers.
Yeah.
You are represented. You don't have to quote section banbani of which act. You are anjo kulumi daba ya coach. We are unkole them. You should tell a video. Sazwana ng 5,000 manjo muntu wong balege. Then they give you a date. You go to commissioner. That's a small claims court. Up to 20,000 rand. You just go to your closest magistrate court. Back nuga zama form. You fill them in claim. You spend less than 1,000 rand and lapo gubo sheriff, like just utama sheriff akambisele. Sometimes they even allow you to hambise ngama police if you really don't have money.
Yeah.
Then there's district court up to 200,000, regional courts, still in the small towns, ne? Yeah. Then there's high court. High courts, they are usually in your metros or the capital city.
Yeah.
Yes, like we have one in Bombela, in Mpumalanga, we have one in Middelburg, Johannesburg, there's one. Kanjalo kanjalo. Those are the bigger courts. They deal with bigger cases. Your claims of 400,000 and up, or your claims like I'm a case I'm a cool man that change your status. Maybe ufuna ukuphikisa indaba ye will.
Yeah.
You will have to pick a small claims court. There are certain cases that you need to start at the high court. Yes.
Go and then, straight there, yeah.
Yes, there's the appeal court, SCA, and then there's your constitutional court, which is the highest court. Yeah.
In the land.
Yeah, in the land.
We've been hearing that a lot.
Yeah.
People have available TI, CIA,
constitutional court. Yes.
Sure. So for someone, what advice would you give to someone who, my youngsters here who thinks, I don't know, what advice would you give them?
You know, the best advice I can give them is to expose themselves to that field before by chooser. Mina, I was lucky. That's why I need to be in my story.
Yeah.
I survived by grace. If bekungathandanga uNkulunkulu would have had problems because of like in case into bengayazi, what if bengayithandi? You know, so with them, bane exposure to information. So even if it's not just law, like you want to become a journalist or you want to become a doctor or you want to become a photographer, like lento ufuna ukuba yiyo, ithi ngama holiday, like June holidays, hamba uyocela kuleyo company ukuthi yazi ngibona ngathi ngithanda i-law or ngibona ngathi ngithanda engineering, ngicela ukuthi ningithathe for 1 week. Like, can I just shadow? You know, even if you've studied that course and I will tell them, you're still applying, go and shadow. Ukhona ukubona ukuthi lento lena, is it really? Because a lot of youth, first of all, like this thing, we waste our parents' money. You know, you take 50,000 of your parents, uhambuye MGI or uye kubaba patali flat. After 1 year, when I saw you failure, or you just bored, you're like, lento le, it's not really my passion. Or you're not good at it because it's not what you are gifted in.
Yes. As whereas you could have
circumvented that. Yeah. So even not just students, parents should encourage their children. Like, make the appointment. If you're born with umntana kungatiwa vila panyana, mkulumele nabantu, go and ask. Ngicela ukuthi umntana wami azo. Because sometimes the mistake that people, young people, sibeka imali phambili. Nobody wants to do the groundwork.
Yeah.
You know, even people who are qualified, you find umuntu athi ngine degree yelo. Hlatshwayo, I need 15,000 from you every month ukuthi ngizokusiza. Then I'm like, uzongisiza njani? What do you bring to the table?
Whatever, yeah.
No, just a simple question. Okay, ngizokunika. And that's even with people who are in law, we have that problem. Umuntu afike ku interview, the only thing ayaziyo ukuthi yena ufuna 15,000.
Yeah.
First question, what are you... Kuma relationship sikichimela pambili kukubuza logo. What do you bring to the table?
To the table, yeah.
I want a man...
I'm the table.
You know, I want a man who drives. I want a man.
Yeah.
But when... What do you bring to the table? You must be able to answer that. You would, okay, mina, I want 15,000 rand. I can draft a letter. I can drive. I can do this. How are you going to make my life easier? Why do... Because that's what employers are asking.
Yeah.
Why do I need to hire you when there's 10 other people applying for the same job?
Yeah.
What makes you different? So, people must prepare for that when they want to enter into any market. What are you bringing to the table?
Yeah.
So, if you did maybe job shadowing, you went for a week, you've got something to put on your CV. You could know, mina ngasebenza ehlatshwayo attorneys, and then ngafunda ukuthi nokuthi nokuthi. Mangiza la ehladla attorneys or whatever. This is what I bring to the table. So, at least you are 2 steps ahead of the pack.
Yeah. It's not like you just woke up and be like, I want to work for JM.
So, do your research. Try to expose yourself to those fields. Before actually entering them.
Yeah. So, with all, I believe your profession requires a lot of time.
Yeah.
How do you balance work schedules and Neskat's family? I mean, obviously, you're married.
Yo.
Sorry to ask you. Are you married? Excuse.
Yeah, no.
But the you have a family.
Yeah, I do have a family. I do have kids.
Yeah. talk about marriage and stuff. Okay, we'll get to that. But how do you balance
my personal life and you know what, ne? Sometimes my employees have to like say to me, siyacela, sicela ukuthi uthathe off. Sicela uphumule. It's hard. The other weekend I switched off my phone, I spent time with my kids. You know, both of them actually came like bangibonga bathi mom, thank you so much for spending time with us. And that's bad.
Nah.
That's terrible because it means ukuthi like I'm working too hard.
Too much.
That isikhathi
sabo. Don't have time for.
Siba sincane. But it's not only with law.
Yeah.
You know, any career that you are dedicated to making a success of, it's going to be like that. Especially when you're still trying to build a brand. You want to make something of yourself and your brand. Uzoba naleso. Like, you're going to have that challenge with you, I'm working too hard. But probably once you get to a certain level, you can relax and let other people maybe run it. But it's so difficult. It's so difficult when you want to be successful. It's so difficult when you want to make it work. Because, for example, with myself, like, I'm an owner of a business. I'm a director of JM Hlatshwayo Attorneys. Angeke ngize ngivume, like, ama client angaphatheki kahle, you know? Angeke umuntu afune isevisi yami ngithi kuye no ngibhizi. Ngicela ukuthi ngizokufonela after 2 weeks. Uzohamba komunye umuntu. You know? So you always want to make sure that you
clients are happy,
you're providing the best service, you're putting your name out there, you're getting those recommendations. And that requires time.
True.
That's why there are people who'll be successful and there are people who won't be successful. There's no way uzologu and then you think you're gonna have this global brand or this national brand. So even with other people, you know, I worked with the IEC now during elections, and there was the PO of Mpumalanga, you know, and I worked closely with him. I was so inspired. Like umama, even about 8-9 ebusuku uthumela ama message, you know, she's not having a private company, like the IEC is not her private company, but she's a successful PEO who's running elections in her province. Like 5 in the morning, she's up.
Sure.
She's sending emails at 11. Like when I'm all email at 10. So you're already behind trying to catch up.
Sure.
So with anything that you want to make a success of, you need to put in effort, you need to put in work. But it's important to also strike that balance and like for me now, what I did, I just simply bought a personal phone.
Okay.
And then I have the work phone.
Yeah.
Mang feel angathi ngifuna ukuba nabantwana bam. I will switch off the business phone and then nobody has that number. Yes. Only my helper and my parents in the case of emergency.
Yeah.
But you need to switch off. And this is something that when I started, I was so bad at it. Like I actually developed depression because I wasn't switching off. You're always on autopilot.
Yeah.
And it's so unhealthy. You need to have periods of time where you just switch off and you reboot. Even if you read some of the success books or these motivational books, they'll tell you that rest is a very pivotal and critical role of like success and whatever you want to build, you also need to rest.
Yeah.
You need to reboot. You need to allow yourself to refresh.
True.
Yeah.
True.
So I'm still trying. I'm working on that.
Sure. Yeah. Hey, Ziyabuya. Because I'm also struggling with that. Because for me now, I would say I work 2 jobs because I have a job and I have what a lot of people would say a side hustle, but it has become a job for me. You understand? So I'm a photographer. Okay, I work for a certain company. Vele, we have shifts every. Yeah, boom. And then, mang fika endlini. It's like sometimes I come back from a night shift, then get home, edit. And bafuna iithombe zabo, bafuna ama video abo. So you edit. So you're losing time with family. So it's also the reason why I asked you, Uguti, do you have a husband? Something came in emqondweni nami ukuthi something about ama divorce.
Yeah.
Let's say I'm a lawyer. then I go through a divorce. Can I represent myself? Because I saw the Thabo Bester thing.
Yes,
he was talking for himself. Yes. I'm like, at the back of my mind, why can't this guy talk for himself? Because he's well spoken in a way.
Yeah.
But the magistrate kept on saying ngizokusiza, but through your representative.
Mm.
So how kwenziwa njani? Can you represent yourself in court?
So not just with divorces, only with any case you're allowed to represent yourself. It's not like a must. You must have a lawyer. You can represent yourself, but it's highly recommended that you have a lawyer, because you know, some of the times you'll be in a setting, they think that lawyers, like, you're just talking blabbing. Mm. You win cases because you blab. No, you win cases because of your preparedness and because of
the knowledge of law.
And how you applied it. Mm. So you don't win cases because you talk too much.
Yeah.
And you don't win cases because you say eloquent instead of good.
Yeah.
Because the English yako iye kuro. No. You can speak like this, but you quote the relevant section
I've seen that. Ulaleluti. But he's winning.
He's winning. Yes. He's making sense.
Yes.
So, Yazin, it's highly, I always say lawyers also have their lawyers.
Yeah.
If I'm getting divorced, I would very much most probably appoint a lawyer to speak for me. One, because maybe I'm emotionally attached. So, but if you have some, that person is not involved. They can think clearly. They're not making any emotional decisions. Yeah. So in terms of if you didn't study law and you need to have a lawyer, I would highly recommend it.
Yeah.
Because you can read up on a situation. Mm. Let's say, for example, you are divorcing.
Yeah.
You've read the internet. It told you that there's a divorce act, but you don't have experience.
Yes.
You've never lost cases before and known that since ngidliwe la, next time I'm going to do this differently so that I can get this result. And that's the main advantage of getting a lawyer, because you have somebody who's like doing this every single day. Yeah. They know, like, let me give you an example. A lot of people will say they want to sue for breach of promise. Last year, we get that a lot.
Is it?
Yeah. But in terms
of women.
Yes. Generally from women,
sure.
But in terms of South African law, like now in 2024, you can't claim for breach of promise.
Yeah.
You could claim for it in 19 ban. So because of you're not a lawyer, you don't have experience in it. Utemo vuli internet, what's a case for a breach of promise. Yes, Nikki case. You have to see Brett Laws versus Van der Meer. What? Yes, in right in your court.
Yeah.
But you don't know that it's outdated. Mm. There's a new case that came after that one that says you don't sue for breach of promise anymore.
Yes.
So because I have experience, I know that. I'm seeing it. And remember, I'm not only learning from my own failures.
Yeah.
I learn from my colleagues' failures. Mm. You know,
yes.
Sometimes I'm sitting at court waiting for my case, maybe with number 5.
Yeah.
There were 4 people before me saying, I want to So that's the advantage of having a lawyer. Mm.
Sure. Talking about Thabo Bester, what do you think about Thabo Bester's whole story? Are you allowed to just have an opinion on that?
Yo, it's difficult. It's just a very, all I can say is that it's a very interesting scenario.
Mm.
And my remark on that is people should just try and be law-abiding citizen.
Mm.
Ungaboni umuntu who got away with corruption and think you'll get away with it. Sometimes you won't be as lucky. Mm. I'm not saying Thabo Bester is corrupt.
Yeah.
So I'm just making an example. Ungathi ngoba ubani wayenza i-corruption or wayenza i-fraud.
Yeah.
And then ikhesi yabazange ingene yaphelile emoyeni.
You don't know what happens. What are they?
Yes. Yeah. And also, another thing, as you're saying, you don't know what happens.
Mm.
I always notice, or I notice a lot that people will compare their case to somebody else's case.
Yeah.
You know, like, let's go back to divorce. Say, no, Antomu divorce yathatha 1 month. Kusho ukuthi nami manga divorce yami izothatha 1 month. Or indoda yaba nishonile estate yathatha 6 months. Kusho ukuthi vele wonke ama estate. No, you can never compare your case to another person's case because you're not dealing with the same set of facts.
True.
You're not dealing with the same set of people. For example, let's say lo muntu lo u divorce e Nigel, when u divorce Secunda. First of all, it's not the same judge, magistrate.
Yeah. True.
You know, it's not the same circumstances. Maybe they had a house, you don't have a house. You know, maybe they didn't have anything, you have something. Yeah. So people must never compare their situation to the next person's situation.
Yeah.
That's all I can say with this whole, like umuntu angathama khotha useless ebayagweba la ngaphandle.
Siyabuya. But umthetho uyasebenza or you think umthetho awusebenzi
until they
was upupile. Amela hlalela. Okay, sorry.
That's fine.
So and Enyinto bengifuna ukuyazi ne you talked about I don't know if you saw this but just nje as a commentary the IEC people bebakhala on social media bathi abakhokhelwanga. Did you see that?
No, but
I didn't. I think 700 for 12 or 23 hours. Someone was complaining. I worked 23 hours and I was paid 700 and contract. How important is reading and knowing the contract? And can you challenge a contract at some stage? Because now, in my small knowledge, Uguti. If, let's say, I give you a contract, the contract I can challenge if, let's say, the constitution doesn't allow whatever that was on the contract. How does one maneuver when it comes to contract? How important are contracts?
Contracts are very important, but what I've realized is that, one, there are people who just don't read them. So you can find that this very same people who are saying, hey, what?
Yeah.
This is unconstitutional. Yeah. They probably didn't read the contract.
But they agreed and signed.
They signed.
Yeah, but we get excited. Let's say, for instance, it's understandable. You end up signing. Yeah. I mean, I'd say most of our black people are desperate for umsebenzi. We need umsebenzi more than anything learning. So contracts obviously born. So you'd say it's important to read.
I think like in from my experience, a lot of people don't read the contracts. By a signer, then after umuntuzo tia kahle ning abuse, but
you signed.
We are born. And if bounga vumi. But you can't sign and then come after and say, but why didn't you challenge before you signed? Because your signing ukuvuma kwakho ukuthi konke lokho kula ngiyavumelana and ngihambiselana nakho. So the important thing, not only with employment contracts, you know what, I'm actually happy to see this trend. I'm having a lot of young people like coming to with their OTPs, offer to purchase property, like my thing is, they come to me and say, Hlatswayo, mina, I'm an engineer, I'm not a legal person.
Yeah.
Can you read this for me? Let's discuss it.
Yeah.
Tell me what's your experience. And 80% of the time, we come up with new things that they're like, wow, I didn't know this. I didn't know which man got the uksaina, a contract, then after 2 weeks, then decide with lendlang saifuni because of pinky, big maybe orange, ngavelen cancel. If you cancel, you have to pay the penalty. They don't even see those things. No, you need to pay agents 50,000 rand. You need to pay the lawyers' fees. So we have a lot of people, like maybe 20% of people, who come and say, "Yeah, but mina, but you signed.
Yeah, you agree.
So it's important before signing.
Yeah.
Go and consult. Not to go see like my consulting lawyers or vuli file.
Yeah.
Where's that sign?
Yeah,
500 rand. Yeah. Okay, be 500. It will save you 100,000 rand. Not to go to Zovulifal, just to come and discuss. Let's discuss this. Tell me in your experience, what's your experience with these contracts? How does it usually work? What are the fine prints, you know, because a lot of people don't read fine prints. I mean, I'm a lawyer, so I'm like, you know, but if you, it's not something that you're doing every day, it's like, I'm showing you bang rope,
Because also these big, we always have that faith, these big companies, they are, athembekile bathembeke angeke ebangidayisele into expiring ngathathu yahamba whereas mawufika endlini I've encountered a lot of those things ukuthi awu uthathe ukudla and you're like but it's a big company why would they? I mean people make mistakes sometimes but kunabantu abazokwenza nje because I mean behind the whole or the big company they are human beings and some of them can take shortcuts or
it's true.
Yeah. Another case. I just wanna see what you think about them. We saw a lawyer, a lady lawyer, representing Gcinile'. You know, Gcinile'. No, Hrotman. Their story. Hrotman, ufagama private videos on social media. Our Gcinile'. Wabo. So then our faga. Then Gcinile'. Got the lawyer. Then the lawyer, after, okay, Cesar's with you, lawyer one, well, again, like social media, and she started talking. Is that allowed? Because a lot of people were like, I mean, you're not supposed to talk about your client like that. Why are you on social media? Why are you talking so much on social media about your client? Is that allowed? Did you follow that case or that story?
You know what? I'm glad you gave me a background because I didn't follow that case. You know, there are so many cases now. Thabo Bester, there's so much because Nancy, we also have our own clients. Sometimes we don't get time to follow a certain case because now money, and it doesn't mean that because umuntu azanga follow a case is not a good lawyer whatever. Yeah. So, but what I can say in general, there are certain professions that require you to have a certain personality. Yazi mele ukuphapha kwakho kube ne boundary kube nokuthi yazi la angifiki la. You know, so as a lawyer, you have to have a certain dignity. And I'm a client akubheka logo, you know. Mina uma ngibhekile, ask yourself, my client, okay, like, abobani, because we see her thriving, but we don't know her clients. Like, secrecy and privacy, for some people, they really value that. I can't do your divorce, kusasa sengishuda nawe ngiyakufaka uthe successful divorce, USK, how will you feel?
No, it's
like when Ula says, you are doing photography, you are saying, should they now? Like, when I'm able to just divorce, this tomb, saying, a successful divorce, SK is so happy with my services. Yes, you go la, ekumele sibe ne limit, not just only with law, like business in general, like career in general, professionalism. In general, kona abantu abangafuni indaba zabo zi. Like even myself, kona like la engifika khona ngithi ibadlana, you know, let me, you know, I'll give you an example. And I get this a lot. I'm an agent. Mawathengisa izindlu, ne? I'll stand in front of the house. Hey, congratulations, SK, on your house. Hey, but mina, I don't want people knowing. Or maybe uthengi polo lape, VW. Sakafuna ukufaka kuma page wabo yonke. There are people who don't appreciate that.
Yeah.
You know, and for me, I feel that there are a lot of people who come to me because of angisi loyo muntu loyo. You know.
Publicize every case.
Yeah, you know. Like, I don't do that. It's not good. In the profession, vele, I can't do your case and you're figuring your kuluma lapango SK. It's very unprofessional.
Yeah. But is it lawful to do that? Because that's another thing. Is it lawful? Are you by law allowed or is it okay?
It's not okay.
Yeah.
As I was saying, with certain professions, there is goodness and there's expected from us. With lawyers, the standard is like 20 times more. We have a body. Like a corporation is bigger, ukuthi senza kahle asitshontshe imali zama client si professional senza konke kahle, so they bias check and then they can discipline you ukuthi wena manje ngathi sokumele sikwenze kanje sokumisa kancane sinzeni. So I always caution lawyers ukuthi just try your most to be professional, try your most to be ethical. Vele into yokukhuluma indaba zabantu, unprofessional. As much as there's no ikhona i-act edila nama lawyer, like le legal practice act idila nama lawyer nokuthi simele sisebenze kanjani, but ezinye izinto maybe zibhalwe vague, maybe the rule will say, or the in the act they'll say lawyers must always conduct themselves in a professional manner.
Yeah.
Bese, like, you need to always apply the law to the circumstances. Okay, mina mangihamba ngiyokhuluma nge-client lami kanje.
Yeah.
Is it professional? You know, into esivumelene ngayo na.
Yeah.
Uyabo? How does it
also come with the consent of the person? Mm. Obviously, like in my case, I try by all means, ukuthi, whenever I take pictures of you, I also say, are you okay with me posting these? Because maybe I like them, I want to post them, I want to promote my business, right? So it's also a matter of consent.
Consent, yeah. Mm. But yes, you always must use your value judgment. Mm. I'm going to give an example.
Yeah.
Ngiyakubiza SK ngicela ungishuthe ama notes. Noma ngavuma mara nawe kumele uzibuze ukuthi mara lento le ngiyenza ikho right. Uyabona? So there must always be a value judgment, especially in law.
Yeah.
You know, ubheke ukuthi like mara before ngimbuza.
Yeah.
Quite as news, you don't even need to ask ukuthi you know, now goes bambi now ubona ukuthi there are circumstances where you can ask, but khona la mele uzibambe khona mara mele ngizibambe la
ngathi especially there
the line.
Yes, true. Especially there are those ngizothini unemthetho but engekho
exact ukuthi ungenzi ukuthi
exactly. For instance, going back to my field as well, whenever I take pictures of you, let's say it's a maternity photo shoot, a lot of us black people asithanda ukuthi siveze lezinto lezi until mntana sekavelile. Exactly, so I know that as well. Good. I need to wait. Mntana vele, then I can maybe ask or whatever. You don't
because
it's a moment your mom do labo, and you need to respect that. Asithi nje ngcampu kuma divorce and ilobola. I mean, we the LNR. Mangilobolile. By law, I'm married.
Generally speaking, yes. But I want to caution. Yakhumbula ngitheni kuwe.
Yeah.
Ungathathi situation yomunye umuntu. Uyenze isituation yakho.
Yes.
I'm going to be honest with you, ne?
Yeah.
Customary law in South Africa is a gray area. Mm. And it's so unfair. There is an act. Yeah. Edila ngama customary marriages ukuthi ya mele mawulobolile uya, and you know what, leyo act leyo ikhuluma ngokuthi maba kulobolile umfazi. So with every case, it's again a value judgment ukuthi, because ama case awafani, like umtsonga maybe ngumzulu ubani umsuthu. First of all, the law is not, I mean the customs are not the same. Abanye khona ukuthi ngikulobolile mara sahlala 1 month ngabona ama true colors wakho.
Yeah.
And then now after globally let's sahlala 1 month so funny pension yami 10 years. No. Must challenge this. Khona mina ngokucabanga kwami ne.
Yeah.
When they made this law yokuthi like umuntu mamlobolile umfazi wakho, I think they were going for, I'm going to give you an example. Abogogo bethu, rabo mama bethu, some of them uthola ukuthi umuntu uhlele no babakho 20 years abasayinanga.
Mm.
Marindoti yakhe.
Yeah.
They've been living together as husband and wife for 20 years.
True, yeah.
Or for 10 years, or for 5 years.
They were building together.
They built together.
Yeah.
In the days of very... So, uhamba ne 2000.
Yeah.
Ushiya lo gogo.
Ufuthi awuhambi nalo. Thathi ucosha ugogo.
Ucosha ugogo.
For 2000 ekhaya.
Uyabona ukuthi...
It's not fair.
It's not fair.
Yeah.
But manje, again, it's... But injali impilo ne. Then you find people who abuse... You know, the system.
Yeah.
Uthola umuntu, mina nawe sihlale 3 months.
Yeah.
Uyabo? Then ngavela kini. Maybe bengiyobhadala ama damages. Maybe senza umntwana, then ngiyobhadala ama damages.
Yeah.
So uyayijika wena, so uthi lo muntu usishadile. So ufuna ipension yami yasesasole.
Sure.
Uyabona ukuthi these two situations as fine. So when they made this law, I believe they were trying to protect the former. And there will always be people who
try.
Angithi mawuna 3 months uhlele umuntu oshadanga, but I'm just trying to make an example. Kukhona nokuthi there was this famous case, the double HP case. You remember u double HP Begana lo sisilo.
Yes.
And then
Ulirad.
Yes. Washon WHP.
Yeah.
And like Benkana lo muntu, I'm the one who was putting up with him.
Yeah.
Then Magashona, if Emily a figiti puma. Let it care the motto. No. That can't be fair. So I believe these laws were there to protect those type of instances.
Yeah.
So Agushuguti, when you maybe share no muntu, imagine now people who are saying, yeah, among share no muntu more than 6 months. Umthetho I mean, was lawyer.
I've heard something like that before. But yeah, at some stage, wahlala nomuntu isikhathi esingaka, wamenzela izinto kushuthi njadile.
No, kunento ebizwa nge life partnership. But now uyalizwa legama ne life partner. Uyabo? Angeke ngihlale nawe this week. Next week sewe life partner.
Hayi. Kahle.
Yebo, there must be.
Yeah.
That's the thing with law.
To make sense, yeah.
That's the reason why I would say people must get lawyers. Like ama situation awafana. Ngeke uze uvele uthi ngoba ubani kuthe nami nakimi kunjalo, yabona. So there are different scenarios. Kukhona give another example. Uyazi ukuthi mawushade nomuntu ne nayo sign home affairs in community of property.
Yeah.
In terms of the law, if near divorce, it's 50-50.
Yeah.
But there's a law that says if you feel that that person didn't contribute enough and they caused umshado ukuthi uphele, you can ask the court ukuthi abadeviate from this. Some people don't know that. So umthetho unama khona khona.
Because also, yeah, true. Because njengoba usasho, we can get married. Maybe in community of property. But mean I have my own agendas. Ngithi okay, masiqede ukushada ngenza so. Then down the line I make sure ukuthi maybe I go cheat so that uzongibamba ungilahle. Then I know ukuthi I'm getting your 50%.
Yeah, that's then terrible.
I mean kunabantu aba who have their own
agendas.
Exactly.
Yeah.
So yeah, I don't know isikhathi sime kanjani, but yeah, I still
no, I'm not in a hurry.
Yeah. I just want to make this because I've seen, I think on TikTok, I think they watch a lot of those American videos whereby a police will come to you, then you refuse this. Ngifinjwa ipolisa or whatever, but bayangibopha or ngizoboshwa. What are my rights? Also scared that you just general. What are my rights? Do I tell them, hi, Aksimi, I'm Kwazile, or what do I do? Because you also, Batin, you have the right to remain silent.
Remain silent, yeah.
So can I keep quiet until he's on your figure?
That's your biggest right.
that until
you
I get there.
Exercise that right. You have the right to remain silent. Yeah. Like you have. Mina, I don't. You can sue. You can sue.
But,
you can sue for that.
Okay.
You can sue for the police assaulting you. Mina, I always say, cooperate with the police.
Yeah.
Mabazokubopha, bazokubopha, bazangizokubuza.
Yeah.
Mabeze, ngenhloso ukuthi bazokubopha.
Yeah.
Bazokubopha. The mistake that people make, amaphoyisa mase bafikile, umuntu uvela confess iqiniso, ngicabanga ukuthi mangabatshela iqiniso. They will use that against you. So, and I know people feel so bad, like, to keep quiet. Because police, when they come and arrest you, they will ask you. And just say, which I have the right to remain silent. Maba kwenza sama statement. Ubale, maba tisana la uti, I will make my statement with my lawyer. Or I will make my statement at court. Because we do, unfortunately, we do have instances where people feel pressured to make a statement.
And make a confession under
duress.
Yes.
But I don't want to make it seem like police go around putting people under namang
funu bosha.
You know, but there are circumstances where people do feel maybe from their own pressure. But it's a common thing. You statement a statement, you're going to have a problem.
Sure.
You're going to have a serious problem. Remain silent.
Yeah.
But if bakubophela into ongayazi, you will come to JM Hlatshwayo Attorneys so kwenze le unlawful arrest si claim imali enengi for ukuthi bakubophe unganacala. Yes,
because ukuboshwa now comes with a lot of trauma. Yeah, so you can, so in South Africa we can claim for trauma,
you can claim pain and suffering, you can claim for unlawful arrest, you can claim for trauma,
but do you have to prove that you went through a trauma while they were arresting you? Because
not really. Angithi I case yakhe izongena court, wena ne lawyer lakho nezotshela i court the way you were so traumatized, how engafika lapha bekungana ama tissue ngaba ngenzisa ama squat iboshwe. That's trauma. You don't need a psychological evaluator to tell you that that's traumatic. That's traumatic.
Everyone knows.
Everyone knows. And the court can also remember maslapha asikhulumi nomshini.
Yeah.
Nalo muntu esimtshelayo uyakhona ukuthi yo, but imagine siba kwenzisa ama squat. That must be traumatic.
Yeah.
They also apply their own judgment there, but let the lay correct. You know, you can't just get there cala ushaya umuntu ngimpama so uyambopha. Uthola ukuthi umuntu o wrong akazi nokwazi ukuthi, you know.
So the process of my question, let me go nale. Is the legal system working in South Africa? Does it work? Because, I mean, a lot of people, let me give you an example. A woman, uyahlukunyezwa by a boy from next door. We are boshwa the following day or whatever. We are puma, sekahamba the same street. Then the lady feels ukuthi, eish, I was failed by the law. Is the legal system or umthetho uyasebenza na?
Yo, you're putting me putting me in a very tight position. But what I can say about the legal system, if I have to nifanise na something, ngasho ukuthi iyafana ne health system. You can derive. But there are people who get assisted.
Yeah.
Ukhona umuntu ozothi maybe I had a free lawyer or ngadlengulwa ngasizo.
Yeah.
Ukhona ozothi
mina isanging sis.
But the main problem engibonayo, it's resources. You know, resources, and I'm not ashamed to say this, resources are a problem like South Africa, you know, because of, for me, like it feels unfair. Let me use the Senzo Mewe case. Umuntu ubulelwe 10 years ago. Zambi case namanje. Iyophela nini le trauma? So if maybe the court had less cases, or there were more courts, or there were more judges. Yabona ukuthi sikhuluma ama resources.
Yes.
Resources.
Bezophusha.
Bekuzophusheka. Because one of the things efaila abantu is the time and delay. Ukuthi like, okay, ngidlengulwe ngo 2010, i-case yami izongena 2015. What's causing that? There's no law that says a rape case must take 5 years or must take 10 years. Or it should be finalized as speedily as possible. But see, what do we have a problem with? Load shedding. And that's a question I get a lot. Which, but mina ngifila ngathi case yami ayimovie. Ngine lawyer, but ngibona ngathi iloku ayingeni. Kanti ayiloku ingangeni. Uyabona nawe, iloku iyarimindwa. You know?
Yeah.
Niafiga, the problems that people face, niafiga kothi amanza weko. Get remind.
I can proceed.
I'm a case, let's say in a Monday, I'm a case I 20, magistrate we one. The case A1, it's at 5 hours. Obvious, we're going to do 1 or 2, 18 will be postponed. Next time, say abu, I'm a case. So resources, if there were more magistrates, more courts,
would have been
more machines, more buildings. I'm not saying pela manje sesi. You know, like, I'll give an example.
But kube functional.
Kube functional. Abantu basembalenhle, they attend court in Evenda.
Yes.
Evenda yenza ama case wase King Rose, yenza ama case wase Mbalenhle, yenza ama case wase Evenda, yenza ama yo.
Kuningi.
Imagine like Leslie iyodwa yabe ningakanani.
Yeah.
Some they do have a court in Leslie, but it's a periodic court. You know, like
what is that?
Periodic court means they don't come every day. They come on a period, on a certain period.
Yeah.
We are born. And some of the cases, like Ilias, they are in a divorce. Abantu ba divorce, ay basele esli yendrach, they need to go to a Evenda.
Yeah.
And in Balenhle could have a court or two.
Yes, yes, on its own.
A court or two.
I think
two.
Out of all these, the local places, Imbalenhle has got more people, I would say.
We are born. So, I don't know. I wish our government can
just, I
Like, yeah. Because it's so traumatizing. Like, you're already having, let me say, the trauma of you are going through a divorce. Now you must also go through the trauma of you divorce her for 2 years.
Sure.
Imagine.
Your life imile.
Imile.
You can't do anything. You can't get married to a new whatever.
You can't, yeah. Like, you have a divorce. You can't buy a car because you have to go 50-50. You know, you can't,
But how difficult are rape cases in your...
Rape cases are very difficult. I mean, I do, I'm a GP, general practitioner, so I do criminal law, I do family law, civil law. Kona my case,
That's another thing I wanted to ask you, yeah.
I do a rape case, ne? Ikhona into yabona lento yamavuso.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Yabo? Yeah. And I've won like a few cases anjalo. Not ukuthi amavuso. Maybe siyazwana. When so funny imali or you catch me I catch you cheating. Me and you were in a relationship. I catch you cheating. Then I
Then you say
sengithi ngirapile. Akukhona ama case anjalo. Kukhona ukuthi vele ungirebhile yabo. I'll give an example laba babukela iskim sam. That storyline yaka Ntswaki. Ntswaki pursued this guy. She even lied about who she is. She said, I'm a varsity student. While she knew ukuthi umntana esikolo ufunde high school, ufunde grade 8, grade 9. That guy, makana lo Ntswaki, he has that image ukuthi uNtswaki umntana wase varsity. And uNtswaki lokhu uyangilandelela, uNtswaki ungi-invitile. Masifika, senza konke. Siba ready, siya prepare. All of the sudden, sengiyaboshwa. Uyabona ukuthi na, I hate that storyline because there's a lot of guys who go through that. Yeah. As much as there are a lot of ladies who are being raped, truthfully so.
Yes, yes.
But there are also a lot of guys who are being accused unfairly for something. Or accused falsely. You know, so that's why I need to, yes, rape ngiyenza, yes, criminal lawyer ngiyenza, but I choose my cases. I have that luxury because I'm not a state lawyer. Private lawyer. I have that luxury to choose ukuthi. It goes against my own principles. It goes against, like, mele manyo kumela lapha nami ngingazizwa ngathi ngiyafafaza. Mele lento engiyikhuluma ne judge libona ukuthi no, but uhlatshwayo lento le, yes, ngiyamuzwa. But mangiyela lapha ngikho sho hayi ngiyodliwa mos.
Yo.
Uyabo?
Then it's a minus on your side.
So. You and I don't like losing.
Yeah.
I don't like losing.
You are so competitive, they say. Yeah.
Very competitive, yeah, that's beautiful. Yes.
I think we should do this more. I've learned a lot. Even though mhlambe ama terms ngawazi and when we are, yabo. So, but I've learned. So, what do you think? Can we do this more?
You know what? Yes, yeah. Please, once a month. Yazi khona just the topics I'd like to cover.
Yeah.
Yama estates, amafa, ama will.
Yes.
Mangishonela abazali.
What happens?
Where to start? Mangishonele indoda.
Yeah.
Where to start? You know, I like people.
Like family funa ungikhiphe endlini.
Ama wili.
What do I do?
Yo, it's so sad. It's so sad, like, to build an empire or to build. Ube nendlu, ube nemoto, or ube nemoto kuphela.
Yeah.
Bona izinto zakho zidliwe. Ushonile. Your kids are left with nothing just because you didn't have the information.
Also, I know we need to touch a lot because I also wanted to touch on the maintenance side. Ukuthi ubani kumele maintain, what happens there? Because I mean, sometimes siyenza lezinto kube ngazathi as men, makumele ku divorce doda phuma endlini hamba uchashe I room or whatever, because you understand. So but I think once a month can do.
I will be very delighted.
So
it's so painful when SK ne, like seeing umuntu going through something, because bigangas. And sometimes, you know what, to be honest, sometimes you can't blame the person.
Yeah.
Because they don't have access to that information.
Information, yeah.
Yeah. Just a simple thing, good, like, now you went through it. Yeah, I never look reminded. The criminal record. Simple things like that.
Yeah, because maybe at some stage you would get to that space, Yoguti. When are you allowed to speak in court? What should you do? You can't just stand up, hey, go send a dollar.
So Bosha was too.
But in contempt of court.
Yes. But I'll be delighted.
Yeah, no, beautiful. Where do they get you when they need to consult? Consulting is 500.
Plent.
Yeah.
Plent.
They should know.
But I'm just joking.
Yeah.
Okay. So before Ngiyagu, where should we consult? Yes, I feel like imagine. I'm gonna speak for a lot of lawyers.
Yeah.
Unfortunately or fortunately, I don't know, we are moving into a digital age.
Yes.
In our Facebook page, we've got WhatsApps and so on.
Yeah.
Umuntu uzokuthumela WhatsApp engakho.
Mm-hmm.
If ngizohlala, just think about it, ne? If ngizohlala the whole day lo ngiphendula ama WhatsApp ukuthi like abantwana bamabodlana.
Yeah.
Labo sesengibachashile. You know? So, and a simple thing, how to have access to a lawyer. Yes, ngine Facebook page, but I don't have time to lo ngiphendula ama free advice wabantu.
Yeah.
For us, go onto our Facebook page, JM Hlatshwayo Attorneys. Well, yeah. Look, my inbox, very inbox. I'm really bad at that. Get the number for the office. Call the office. Hi, mina ngu S Mahlangu. Ngicela ukwenza i-appointment ngelanga elinje. And then 500. Uze wiphet. Like, you know what, ne? Some of the information that we take for granted. Like, ukhona umuntu ofikayo athi ngizobona i-lawyer akaphethanga ngisho 100 rand ngosami. Like, then you like this person, usukile wageza, like elokishini, or Secunda, or whatever. Where's they took the time? Maga figa la, me la kipi 500. Uchi bengaz. A lot. And I feel so bad. Like, I feel.
So but now you don't know what to.
And it's, but now, since like a company ikhulile, remember that people who are depending on me.
Yes.
It's not just me alone. Angwazi ukuzicabangela ngiyi-one. And also, the people abasebenza now, you need to pay them well. People must earn well. People must have cars. People must for them to be happy. Because as much as they are helping people, they've got expenses. They also need to be happy. So I can't be selfish. If mina ngizoloko ngizwela abantu, it means these ladies, I'm failing them. You see. So call, make an appointment. Mawuza. Consultation fee uzanayo 500 rand. Then you come ukhuluma ne lawyer.
Yes.
Umuntu angathi maqeda ukonsulta athi sengine file kusho ukuthi divorce yogijima the whole year nge 500. Mara nawe icabanga kuthiwa ubhadale 500 uyenza case for 6 months.
You can't.
Mhlambe ni 5 enginenzela ama divorce. Kusho ukuthi for le 6 months mina ngisebenzele 2500 rand. Labo sisi.
Yeah, badlani.
Lama iPhone abaphatha ababhadala kanjani.
Talk about abosis. How many employees do you have?
Okay, so we currently have a permanent staff of four or five. Mm-hmm.
Beautiful.
We have hired 3 more.
Mm-hmm.
They're gonna start in July. So what we did, because every different level of your life requires a different you. Like mangqala bengiyiwana, I was fine working from home, then I got another lady sabayi 2-3 kanjalo ne. Now what I've realized ukuthi the company must grow, mele kube nama claims handler. You know makuthiwa une, let's say une policy eAbsa.
Yeah.
Uyazi ukuthi mina mangifika lapha ngikhuluma noSthembile. So I've started a new system with mele kube nama department within the law firm. Mele kube ne divorce department. Umuntu maka ne divorce azi ukuthi mina kulela office I'm dealing with this person. Ku estate so that's what I'm trying to do now, and I'm just God has blessed me. I don't want to lie, and I want to also be a blessing to others. That's my location now.
Blessing you are. Thank you so much. You are contributing to reducing unemployment. Soon we're doing this again. It has been the LNR podcast. Thank you so much. Subscribe, do the right thing. If you need what was the thing, Pila? Okay, I had my own segment or advertising voice, but advertise the thing. But
thank you.
If you have a problem, just give a call to, and you make me feel better when I hear WhatsApp. I'm bad when it comes to that. I even try to give that to my wife to handle that, because at least my phone moon, I get to say, okay, as ganja as enze ganje appointment or this meetup. It's easier that way.
You know what, ne? As small business black people, we struggle with professionalizing the business.
True.
And then kubangati unprofessional, but it's just the systems that we need to put in place. I also struggle with that. I also struggle with, like, gune phone as an office, ne? Gine cell phone your business, gine personal phone.
Yeah.
For some odd reason, people will want to call me on my, they don't want to call the office and book an appointment.
They
and
want
I think
direct.
As customers, we must also learn to professionalize ourselves if we want the service provider to take us seriously. Now I need to go to into Zamalu, loku, Zamukna Patalu, loku. Hey, SK, Bonilu, to your mobile next week, Ngalu Patti cameras on shoot and you fast. No, book an appointment with SK. SK, anyone's good to. You know, SK, can I please book you? This is the language that we should be speaking as customers. SK, ngicela ukubhuka next week Saturday ngine party yomntwana. What are your rates? Ungathi hi. U expect ukuthi u SK, how are you? HUD, WD. Hi SK, I have an event on Saturday. I want to book you. How much are your rates? Do you request the deposit? Pay for the service. Uzobona ukuthi abantu abamnyama ba professional.
Yeah.
Uzobabona abantu abamnyama ukuthi ba professional. Hi HUD. Ah ngabingelela lapho wathula nami ngathula. Hawu SK uyachosha. No.
No, it's not like that. Eh, by the way, yeah, if unenkinga ke nakhohla. Nize ngapha ekhaya. So yeah, it has been the LNR podcast. Thank you so much for tuning in. Siyabonga. What else? Oh, good reminder again. I was with my team. Well done to the team. Must do this more. Yeah. Sharp. It has been the LNR podcast. Hey, pela namapetri. But yeah. Good. Peace. Bye.